Santa must love you very much, darling.
He certainly does. Well, all right, sport, what do you want to open up first? How about the biggest one?
No, I'm gonna save that one for the last.
It's a very sound choice. Always save the best for last.
Can I start opening them?
Well, absolutely. Go ahead, tear into them. Hurry up, come on.
Go get them. Cece. You've made this Christmas so very happy for him.
He's done the same thing for me.
That's to say thank you from the both of us.
What took you so long to wake up?
Mother, I thought all that pounding was in my head.
Oh, and your phone's off the hook. I knew it. Why would you do something like that?
So no one would disturb me, okay?
Don't you dare go back to sleep. I need your help, Warren. Get up and get dressed.
Merry Christmas!
Warren, pay attention. Your father's been put in jail.
What?
Hey, what is this?
Oh,
hey, look what I got.
Hey,
look at this.
I got one too.
Santa must have spent the night in jail.
Yeah, well, I wonder what they got him in for.
Breaking and entering, what else?
Hey, look at this.
What?
See what's in there.
Hey, a police badge. Santa's a clown, too,
yeah.
Huh?
I wish he would have given me one of them get-out-of-jail cards.
Yeah.
No, seriously, where do you suppose all this stuff really came from?
I don't know. Hey. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, you too.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let her receive her King, let every heart prepare him room. Let heaven and nature sing, let heaven and nature sing.
Where's my son? I want you to take me to him immediately.
And who might you be?
I'm Mrs. T. MacDonald Lockridge. T as in tiger.
Mrs. Lockridge, how do you do? I'm Sergeant Dillon.
I don't care who you are. I want to see my son.
Who might your son be?
Not who might he be. He is Lionel Lockridge. It's outrageous that he's here. Arrested. Haven't you people got anything better to do than to arrest innocent people?
Well, I know we have him in a holding cell.
Holding cell?
Yeah, it's where we put all the innocent people we arrest. Now, we don't want them to associate with criminal types and pick up a lot of bad habits. Now, if you hang on one second, I'll see if you can see him.
I know I can see him. I'm his mother.
Can't get over this. Talk about prison reform.
Hurry. I think he spent the night here on Christmas Eve, too.
Oh, there's mother. Sit up, Sid. She hates to see people slouch.
Lionel, look at you. Open this cage door. What are you doing in here?
Merry Christmas, Mother.
Oh, Merry Christmas. Now, who's that?
I'm so sorry. Sid, this gentleman has very kindly deigned to share his room with me. His name is Sid, as I said. This is my mother, Mrs. Lockridge.
Howdy.
Could we talk in private?
Well, we'll do the best we can. Would you excuse us?
Oh, sure, yeah. Go right ahead.
Why don't we step down into this chamber here?
Now, I want to know... Yeah. Did you do what they said you did?
Mother, I didn't rob anybody.
Well, what are we waiting for? Why don't you tell them and let's go home?
Well, Mother, they won't let me go home quite yet. I've been arrested and they haven't even set bail yet.
That's terrible.
Yeah, I know. I'm not too crazy about it myself. The timing wasn't terribly felicitous, was it?
Over the years, Lionel, I've been very disappointed in you. But I watched you on television last night.
Did you?
You were reading the Amanda Lockridge log, and you were magnificent.
Did you really think so?
Yes.
Well, Chuck, that's very nice to hear. Well, what you got in the bag?
Well, I've got a gift for you. Huh? It is a Christmas present.
I've got to check it out first, ma'am.
What? Don't you dare touch it.
I've got to see what's in the box.
I will tell you what's in the box. Christmas cookies that I made with my own hands for him.
We got rules.
Why don't you just let him look, Mother, huh?
I don't like to having my integrity questioned. Nor my cookies.
Hey, give it here.
Oh, Mother.
I brought it for protection in case somebody wanted to touch my cookies.
Now, do you realize that I could arrest you for this right here and now?
Oh, come on, Oscar. She really didn't mean anything. Look, it isn't even loaded.
Don't grovel, Lionel.
Well, you know, I ought to stick you in a cell of your own right now.
Well, do it. Do it, but see that you can face the consequences.
Well, I tell you what. I'm not going to arrest you, but I'm going to confiscate this. And your visiting time is over. Let's go.
I'll be back, Lionel.
Thanks, Mother. Good not try.
Not with no more cookies, you ain't.
Goodbye, Sid.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. Lockridge.
Excuse me, ma'am. I mean, Mrs. Lockridge. May I ask you something?
Yes.
Did you ever take the train from Santa Barbara to San Francisco every week, once a week, for about 6 months?
Why, yes.
It must have happened about 50 years ago. Wasn't it you?
I beg your pardon.
What the devil? Oh, no. I don't believe it. She couldn't... It's a key.
Hey. What's so funny about cookies?
Yeah, she just never gives up, that woman. I believe she thinks I'm the Birdman of Alcatraz. Here, Sid, have one of her cookies.
Hey, what kind are they?
Well, you might call them misfortune cookies. But watch your filling.
Oh, wait a minute. What about mine?
What, do you got a file? Get to work. Start on those bars.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas.
Hey, wait a minute. Something tells me that wasn't Santa Claus. There must be even more incriminating evidence in the Lockridge house. Now that you're looking for a murderer and not just a thief, you should look with different eyes.
That's wonderful.
That's great.
Isn't it great?
Yeah.
That's great. It's really great.
I wonder if she got everything. Oh, Amy, did you get everything?
Everything with the white sauce.
Oh, the white sauce. Well, I'll just have to make the white
sauce. No problem.
No problem. I'll make it.
Yeah. Okay. Why are you two acting so funny?
Who?
Us?
Yeah. Us?
Yeah.
No.
Oh.
Well,
she thinks we're really acting nervous.
Funny.
Funny.
No, wait. No. What is going on? You two are acting like a couple of conspirators. What are you up to?
Ah, well.
Huh?
Should we tell her now?
I think we better now.
Okay.
How would you like to see your Christmas present?
I've already opened up my Christmas present.
Well, not this one you haven't. So I'll just take the bag.
Okay.
Okay. And I'm just going to put it right here.
Okay.
Put the bag down. Okay.
Okay.
And you come with us.
What's going on?
One, two, three.
Ta-da!
Oh, I don't believe it. You like it?
Oh, it's wonderful.
Oh, now, wait a minute. You're not supposed to get all weepy.
Oh. What about the dining room?
Oh. The dining room. Gosh, well, I guess this means we just won't be able to give any more black tie formal dinner parties.
Oh, well. Amy, isn't it perfect? Mom and I made everything, except for the mobile. Danny made that.
Yeah.
And Mom is just an absolute wizard.
I am. Emma.
Look at Rebecca. Oh, look at this. I haven't seen her in
many years.
I was just saving her for the first baby.
Yeah, and Mom made her some new wired glasses.
Yes. I don't know what to say. I am so touched. I'm so moved. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much.
Slow down, darling. You're not taking time to enjoy those things. You're just rushing right through everything.
I want to get to the big one, Mommy.
Of course, you know, Cece, that you're spoiling him dreadfully.
I'm having a great time. You don't mind, do you?
How could I mind?
I think I'm having more fun than he is.
May I say something personal to you?
Of course.
Now, I know that you're not really happy today.
I think you know that, do you?
Yes, I think I know that. Brandon and I care for you very much. But we know we're not your family.
But I think of you and Brandon as my family.
That's because you have such a generous heart. But I know you're missing Kelly. And things are not the way you want them to be with Mason.
I'm all right, Gina. I am. What about you, though? This must be a difficult time for you.
Yes. I miss Doug. I'll always miss Doug. But I'm doing just fine. Say, do you remember the first time we met?
No, I don't think so.
Beverly Hills Country Club.
Oh, you're kidding.
I was caddying for Stockman.
Oh, my. That day?
That's right. I'll never forget it. You landed right in the middle of the fairway in a helicopter because you had some business to conduct with Stockman. That's not the kind of entrance a girl easily forgets.
Well, I'm glad I made an impression on you.
Oh, yes.
Because I was very impressed by the caddy that day.
And now, here I am, living under the same roof. Life takes odd turns, doesn't it?
Very pleasant ones sometimes. I can't stand it any longer. Hey, partner, how about we open up the big one?
Okay.
All right, come on.
Come on, let's do it.
Get the ribbon off. Attaboy. All right.
All right, close your eyes. Ready, ready? Here we go.
Oh, wow. Mommy, Uncle Cece, look what I got.
Oh, just look at that. It's beautiful.
Ooh, Santa must like you very much, Tiger.
I'm a race car driver.
Indianapolis, here we come.
Glad you're here.
Dad, we gotta get you out of here.
Tomorrow. We don't have much time before they bring back my roommate here.
It isn't right for you to be in here because of something that I did. I took those coins, not you.
Don't do anything heroic, okay?
Both Joe and Kelly know that, are suspected anyway, that I was the one that took those coins. It's just a matter of time before Mason finds out about it.
It's all right. They didn't find them in your possession. So even if you're accused, they don't have any proof. Tell you something. There is something strange going on.
Yeah, what's that?
I got rid of those coins, Warren. You know that?
Yeah, well, I knew you said you were going to.
I did. But somebody recovered them and planted them and is trying to incriminate me.
Who? Do you have any idea?
I don't know, but I have some ideas. No proof.
Dad, I still don't like you taking the rap for me, though.
Why? Aren't I doing a good job of it?
Hey, I'm serious.
Listen, it isn't every day that a father gets to take the rap for his son. You're not going to rob me of my moment of glory, are you?
Huh? You call this glory, huh?
Well, if not glory, perhaps sacrifice a little bit of worth. Let me tell you something. My son, I love you. You know that?
I love you too, Dad. Mm-hmm. That's how come this bothers me so much.
Then just shut up and wish me a Merry Christmas, will you? Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, Merry Christmas.
Huh? Oh, Merry Christmas.
We matched one of the John Doe sets of fingerprints from your father's study with Lionel Lockridge's.
You're positive?
Yes, sir. And they were found on the side of the desk where the gun was fired.
Good, good. It helps us a great deal. I want you to know how much we appreciate your pushing us through on a holiday for us. Exactly what I was hoping for. I think we now have Mr. Lockridge exactly where we want him. You have a Merry Christmas.
You made those curtains, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Yes.
And of course, your grandmother made the blanket.
And of course, I made the pillows.
Oh, your old rocker. Mm. You spent a lot of time in this with all three of us kids.
Yes, at the same time.
Oh, Amy, I can't wait to see you sitting there with the baby.
Do you think we could think of some names instead of calling it the baby?
Oh, Jade, I'm sorry. I'm going to get right on this for you. I don't want you inconvenienced. You know? Okay, so I thought maybe, you know, we could call the kid something like George Louise or Louis George. It wouldn't matter. What do you think?
Or,
could I?
We could wait a little bit before naming a baby.
Okay, well, if it was my baby, I would name it first, and then I would have it.
Oh.
I'll race you to the door.
No racing. No. You'll walk slowly from now on, carefully, like a lady.
Okay, slowly, carefully.
I'll run for the door.
Okay.
You can lean on me, dear.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh,
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, girl.
Hey, Feliz Navidad, huh? Did I say that right?
Perfecto. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Ruben.
Yeah.
I bet Danny is still in bed.
Not this Christmas, no.
We gave him a tool kit here.
Oh, Danny loves tools.
Yes, in fact, right now he's rebuilding his car.
That figures. Oh, please, sit down. Please.
Thank you.
All right, now I have to ask. Have you heard from Santana?
Yes, she called to wish us a Merry Christmas and to say that she was all right.
Oh, I'm so glad. You must feel so much better.
Oh, we do. We brought you a little something.
Oh,
Marissa.
So sweet.
Oh, well, make it easy. Amy, you can't have any.
Yeah.
It's for your own good.
Good luck.
Amigos, thank you.
Something for the baby.
Oh, you love Rippy.
Rosa, your quince jelly.
Oh. Rosa, this is beautiful.
Aww.
It must have taken you weeks to knit.
Thank you.
It's just... Well, let me get some coffee, okay? We really can't stay.
Oh, do you know, I feel so embarrassed that I can't reciprocate. I was going to do some baking this year, but then with all the nursery and everything, I just never got around to it.
You helped us with water during the earthquake, Marisa, and we've never forgotten you for it. That's gift enough for 10 Christmases.
Oh, thank you, Rupert.
Amy, Jade, have a very nice day.
Oh, Rosa, thank you again for thinking about the baby. I really, I appreciate it.
I enjoy doing it,
Merry
dear.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, sweetheart.
Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Yes.
Say hi to Danny.
We'll do. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas now.
Bye-bye.
Bye. They are so sweet.
It's a wonderful, sweet thing to do.
Mom, do I have time to make a phone call to Danny before breakfast?
Not before breakfast. Oh, I haven't even thought about breakfast. You've got lots of time.
Thanks. See you later.
So glad you're pleased.
Oh, it's wonderful. I saw that you put the family portrait in here, too.
Well, yeah. Kind of like the idea of it being in here.
Yeah.
With the new grandchild. I think your dad would have liked it.
It's wonderful.
You know, when Jade and I were cleaning out the attic, I discovered how sentimental your father really was.
Was he?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Saved everything. Christmas wrapping paper and birthday cards, report cards.
Oh, no.
All the things you and Jade made in school. I was amazed at all the stuff he had. I never knew he saved things like that. I guess I didn't really know him as well as I thought.
Are you okay?
I'm okay.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, your father was really a wonderful man, Amy, in his own way. I mean, I know he wasn't a huge success in his life, but he was a decent man and good and caring and honest. And he had you and Jade and Joey.
I'd like to meet a man just like him someday. Only I don't think they make them anymore.
Oh, no, you will. And I know you will. You know why?
Why?
Because you're just like that.
Am I?
Oh, yes.
Thanks. Mama, I don't care if this baby is a boy or a girl. But if it is a boy, I have decided that I would like to name it John after Daddy.
Really?
Yeah?
Well, I guess that's about the loveliest Christmas present I could get.
Mom, are you all right?
I'd feel a lot better if your father weren't spending Christmas in jail.
I know. I can't believe I finally found out about those coins everybody's been talking about. You know, I didn't even know anything about them until after Daddy was arrested. Why doesn't anybody tell me anything?
Darling, we didn't want to involve you in our problems.
But they're my problems, too, unless I'm in the wrong family.
All right, I'm sorry. I apologize. Next time there are any serious problems, you will be filled in on them. As a matter of fact, we'll wake you up in the middle of the night, if that'll make you happy.
Mom, you're being sarcastic. I'm serious. You know, there's something else that's been bothering me. It seems so strange. What were you and Daddy doing at the cemetery the day of the earthquake? And with Eden?
Did you talk to Eden?
Yes, but she said it was just a coincidence.
Yes, well, it was. It was a coincidence.
Do you trust Daddy?
More than I trust any other man.
You know, I used to really trust Ted. I used to really believe in him, and now...
I know. Well, you can't trust people without asking some questions.
No, I'm beginning to realize that. Hurts.
I know. And the older you get, the more difficult it becomes.
I have made up my mind, and I don't want to hear any argument.
Speaking of older... Really, Minx, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about Christmas dinner. I'm taking it to Lionel in the jailhouse.
Oh, that's great. Mom, can I come too, please?
But of course. It's a possibility.
Oh.
But then, wouldn't be very Christmassy having your father have dinner behind bars... Wouldn't be very Christmassy for any of us.
We are going there. We're going to take him a goose and plum pudding and a whole Christmas dinner.
They threw you out of there once today.
I don't care. We're going there anyway.
Oh.
Come on.
Goose, indeed. I like to cook your goose.
I cooked a turkey.
How does Rosa do this?
Amy, did you see these awful earrings that Kathy gave me?
No.
Oh!
They're awful.
Yeah, I mean, considering I gave her this great twisted sister tape.
Twisted? Maybe she was trying to get even with you.
No, I just don't think some people know the true meaning of Christmas.
Which is to make sure you get what you want?
No, no, but I wish it were. Amy.
Yeah?
Why in this day and age are you trying to learn how to knit?
Because, smart guy, I am trying to learn to be self-sufficient.
Oh, so if you ever get stuck on a deserted island, you could, like, knit a hut.
No. Dear Jade, sweet sister, so I can learn how to be a good mother and make little socks and later on ski sweaters for my kid and save some money.
That's great. But what are you trying to make right now?
Amy, don't ask. But I'm telling you, I'm going to make a go of this and whatever job it is that I get.
Oh, you'll find one.
I don't know. Pregnant knitters market is pretty well glutted. I keep dropping these stitches. This is making me crazy. I mean, I'm not as patient as you might think. Okay, the truth of it is, I'm not very good at this. Knitting, sewing, cooking stuff. I would really like to be, but I'm not.
Amy, you know, you really try and sound cranky about this, but I think you're happy most of the time.
I am. Incredibly.
Because of the baby?
Yeah. I wasn't at first, you know. I didn't expect to be pregnant, and I thought it was probably the worst time for it. But things happen for a reason sometimes. You don't know why or how. And right now, it feels like maybe this was meant to be. You know, that maybe I was meant to have this child.
Maybe you were.
I hope so. All I know is that I'm not going to fight it anymore. I'm just going to be happy. Because I really am, you know? I think I am the luckiest woman in the world. Believe it or not.
I believe it, but I also think you're crazy.
I love you, kiddo.
I love you too.
Mason?
Good morning, Cece. Merry Christmas.
I hope that isn't for me.
Oh, sorry, it's for Brandon. Is he here?
He's already opened up his presents. He's upstairs dressing. I'll take it to him.
I'd kind of like to give it to him myself.
All right, come here.
What a guy.
What made you decide to get a gift for Brandon?
Well, it's not because I think he's a terrific kid or that I saved his life, that we have a great relationship. No, it's purely a political gesture, Dad. Thought I'd better start being nice to the kid who's going to inherit my share of your money. Never know, I might need him for a loan sometime.
You always enjoy being facetious, don't you?
It is the season to be jolly.
All right. What about Lionel Lockridge?
Oh, I don't think he's feeling too jolly this morning.
Well, do you have enough to nail him this time? Do you have enough evidence on him?
Oh, sorry, Cece, it's Christmas. I'm not going to discuss police business with you.
Mason, I have a right to know, and I want...
Perhaps it's the Magi come to call.
Well, good morning, good morning.
Merry Christmas, Cece.
Merry Christmas, Sorcerer. Please come in. Enter your oven. Come in.
We only stopped by to drop off a present that Santana sent to Brandon.
Oh, all right. He's upstairs. Let me call him for you. Gina! Could you ruin Brandon? Come down for
Merry
a few
Christmas,
minutes.
Mason.
Merry Christmas, Rosa. How's Santana?
She's fine. Thank you.
Where is she, Rosa?
I can't tell you, Mason.
I need to talk to her.
She asked me specifically not to tell you or anyone if I was asked. I'm sorry. But she's very well, and she's happy, dear.
I see. Well, tell her I'd like her to change her mind. I have to talk to her.
Hey, there you are. Come on, Rosa has a gift for you.
For me?
Uh-huh. Oh, another present, just what he needs.
Hi, Mason.
Hi, Brandon.
Here you are, dear. It's from Santana.
It is? Where is Santana? We miss her.
She's back east, but she sends all her love, dear.
A camera!
It's an automatic camera, and it's very easy to use. Santana sent a note with it. Do you want me to read it to you?
Yes, please.
Dear Brandon, please take a picture of yourself once in a while and send it to me. I want to watch you grow. I miss you. Love, Santana.
Can I, Mommy?
Well, of course you can, sweetheart. Let's see how it works. We'll take a picture in front of the tree, all right?
Okay. Did we send something to Santana?
Yes, we sent her a card for Rosa.
Come on, Brandon. I got something for you, too.
Oh, hi.
Reuben, I have something for you and Rosa. For you both, Merry Christmas.
In years past, we took your money. This year, we cannot accept it.
Why not? What are you talking about?
After what you did to Santana, forcing her out of her boy's life. We do not want any favors from you, Mr. Kaplan.
Reuben, please take it. You've earned it.
No. Rosa, come. We must be going.
Merry Christmas, Cece.
This jelly that Rosa made is really delicious.
Yeah, it must be. That's your second piece.
I happen to be eating for two, thank you.
Well, you better just be careful or you're going to get big and fat.
Thank you very much, Jade. I appreciate the advice and I will remember it at the moment. I must get back to my knitting.
Oh.
Thank you.
Amy, I have to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
It's about Danny Andrade.
All right.
See, I like him a lot as a friend.
Okay.
But I haven't gotten him anything for Christmas yet.
Oh,
well, anything that I thought was right. I mean, there's sports books and rockets. Right. But then I came up with this really great idea.
Okay.
Okay. Do you think it would be really gross if I gave Danny a date with me as a Christmas present?
Oh, Jade.
Why are you laughing?
You surprised me, that's all.
Well, Amy, don't have your baby on me now.
I'm sorry. I mean, did you think this up all by yourself, or did you need help?
Amy, I know as a matter of fact, Danny Andrade would love that present. I mean, better than a rock tape.
You think he'd like going out with you more than a rock tape?
Yeah, well, he better, or I'll have brick black in both his eyes.
I'm just their gardener.
It's all right. This is official police business.
Even so, this isn't my house. I just can't let you in.
No, believe me. If the owner of the house can't prevent a search when there's a legal warrant, then the gardener speaking for the owner certainly can't prevent it. So why don't you just step aside and let us in?
They'll probably fire me.
Not a chance. Think it's easy to get people who work on Christmas? Okay. Now you check upstairs and we'll look around down here.
Right.
What kind of a present is this?
Hey, we come bearing gifts.
All kinds of food.
Idea, of course, but we all helped. We worked on it.
It's a fine present.
Pass. You pass. Oh, now, yeah. Are you sure there isn't any firearm stuff in that turkey, Mrs. Lockridge?
She'll just have to make do without it this time, won't she?
Oh, well, better than that, we have enough food to feed an army.
Are we really? I'm sorry. Sid, I haven't introduced you to my family. This is my daughter, Lakin.
Hi.
My wife, Augusta. You met Ma Barker over here. And this is my son, Warren.
Hi, everybody. How are you?
Hi.
Hello.
What are you in for, Sid?
Vagrancy.
Oh, that's not so serious. Maybe I can get you out.
Probably
why don't you just keep your motor running and he can make a dash for it? Just kidding, Harry. Listen, excuse me. Harry. You suppose we should bend the rules a little bit and turn this into a real party?
Lionel, go easy. What? We may not be able to feed all of them.
Well, honey, this is a spirit of sharing and caring today. I mean, you know, we have enough turkey if we don't stuff ourselves.
Let's do it.
You and your father are going to feed us out of house and home.
Well, I mean, if we were home, Dad would be inviting the poor to eat with us anyway, wouldn't he?
Yeah, that's right, but I think he'd like it better here, not as many dishes.
That's right. Listen, Harry, why don't you ask the other guards if they want to come in and share a little?
Yeah, I'm sure they would.
Lila, take it easy. That's not possible. We just brought a turkey. We didn't bring loaves and fishes.
Well, if we run short, we can send out.
Maybe we can ask the Capwells to chip in.
We'll put it on their bill.
Can I kiss it?
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Now, this is the true spirit of Christmas, and it was all my idea.
Well, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hello again.
Hello.
Remember before when I asked you about that train?
Yes.
I was a young Rustabout working on the daylight train that summer when you took it up to San Francisco every week. That was you, wasn't it?
Yes, maybe.
You were surely beautiful back then. I mean, I still see that beauty now. I used to see you getting on and off the train every time you got off it. But I never knew who you were.
Why was that?
Well, you see, you made a big impression on me. I never forgot.
No, you haven't. Thank you very much. Have a drumstick.
Thanks.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Here's your grape juice. Okay. Well, God bless us, everyone.
Big Tim.
Didn't I tell you that this was the best way to spend a Christmas?
Yes, you did. And will you read to us later as you usually do?
You think I should?
Oh, please, absolutely. Grandma, this is the perfect place.
I really think you should.
Well, I will. After all, isn't this the most glorious day of the year?
Amen to that.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Cheers.
Sorry, Mr. Capwell. Nothing up there.
Well, I haven't gotten to that corner yet. Check that. I've been able to plant the pictures and things.
Yes, sir.
Oh. What's that?
It's okay. I don't think I broke it.
Well, what do we have here?
What do you got?
There's a ring hidden inside this skull.
Ring? Let me see it. S-C-L-L. Sophia Capwell and Lionel Lockridge. Where have I seen that ring before?
Good.
Good. It's absolutely wonderful. So glad we thought of this.
Thank you.
Well, this really is the way it should be. We're all one people on this earth. Christmas is definitely a time for brotherhood.
You can say that again, brother.
I believe it. We need to learn and share, I guess. Especially those of us who've been given so much. I don't know, perhaps being here, I've been thinking about what Christmas really means, or what it should mean.
What does it mean to you, darling?
Oh, to me it means hope for everyone. For some people, the baby who was born this day came to symbolize the fact that no one is excluded from God's love. I like that concept, but whatever your beliefs, I would like now to wish everyone peace on earth and goodwill toward men. What better way to show it than by doing what we're all doing right here and now, huh? Now, for those of you who would like to join us, Mother, would you bring your Bible with you?
But of course.
Okay. Now, ever since we were children, all of us, we used to listen to our mother read to us. On this day, it's kind of a family tradition, so. Would you read to us, Mother?
I'd be very happy to, darling.
Get that out of your way there. Put it up here.
Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet. Then Herod sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. And when they heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. When they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.